Hi, I'm Matt from eSpares. In this video, I'll be showing you how to test an evaporator fan in a fridge using a multimeter. Now, for this video, we're using a fridge, but the process for testing an evaporator fan in a freezer is very similar. Now, if you've noticed a ticking or grinding noise coming from your fridge that stops when you open the door, it's likely that the evaporator fan has failed. Now the fan circulates cold air around the appliance, so you may notice as well that it doesn't remain at the correct temperature. A multimeter is a test tool designed to measure two or more electrical values for voltage, amps, or ohms. When testing parts in an appliance, you can use the multimeter to check for these measurements. If the reading is above or below the required amount, or there is no reading at all, it means the part is faulty and will need to be replaced. Before using your multimeter, make sure your appliance is switched off and fully disconnected from the mains. For this repair, you'll need a multimeter, a Phillips head screwdriver, and a flat head screwdriver. And you can find a link to these in the description below if you don't already have them. The first thing you need to do is to remove the contents of your fridge, as well as any shelves or drawers. Next, we need to remove the evaporator cover. Before we do that, just check that there's no ice in the screw holes or in the vent, because if there is, it could mean there's ice behind the cover and you will not be able to remove the cover without damaging it. So leave it to defrost for around 48 hours and try again. And it's a good idea to place a towel at the base of the fridge to soak up any water during this process. If you don't see any ice, you can go ahead and remove the cover. First, release the two clips from the top by prising them away with a flathead screwdriver. Then remove the two screws at the top of the cover and the two at the bottom, and also the two screws that hold the tank in place, because you need to remove that as well. You can now pull the evaporator fan cover towards you. There are electrical connections holding it in place at the top here, so just disconnect those and then you can lift the evaporator fan cover out of the way. To get the fan cover off, you need to roll back the foil at the bottom and also the adhesive tape at the top that is holding the wires in. Now, to remove the fan cover, remove the four screws and unclip the wiring. To remove the fan, undo the three screws that hold it in place and pull it away. To set up your multimeter, place the black probe into the black socket at the bottom of the multimeter and the red probe into the red volts socket here. And set the resistance on the multimeter to 20,000 kilo-ohms. To test your fan, you'll need to place the multimeter probes into the plug attached to the wires that you've just unclipped. The plug terminal has three wires: a black, a red, and a white one. You'll need to attach the probes to the black and the white terminals. It doesn't matter which probe goes into which terminal. Now, you are looking for a reading of more than 6 kilo-ohms. Now, if it's less than 6 kilo-ohms, the fan will need to be replaced. If your fan is faulty, I'm now going to show you how to fit a new one. You can find a replacement evaporator fan for your model of fridge freezer, which we have linked to in the description below. To find the right evaporator fan for your fridge freezer, you're going to need the appliance model number. And you can see our video here on where to find the model number of your fridge. Fit the evaporator fan into the place of the old one and refit the screws. You can then refit the fan cover and then reclip in the wiring and reposition the tape at the top and the bottom. You can then place the evaporator cover into position, refit the electrical connections, then refit the screws, two at the top, two at the bottom, and also the two that hold the tank in place. You can then fit the covers at the top, making sure they click into place. Then replace any drawers and shelves, and of course, food and drink. We hope this video has been useful in helping you to replace the evaporator fan in your fridge freezer and it's no longer making any strange noises. Now that your fridge freezer is up and running again, it's a good idea to make sure it's running efficiently as possible and it's not costing you any more money than it should. Check out our video down here for great tips and advice on how to save money and energy when using your fridge. For further help and guidance on how to diagnose, test, and replace appliance parts for your fridge freezer and other household and garden appliances, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.